Blood pressure is what we consider a silent killer because oftentimes people don't have symptoms. And high blood pressure is a risk factor for stroke, for bleeding inside the brain, but also for heart attacks, heart failure, and other causes of cardiovascular disease. So it's important to identify this problem first. And it's so common in our society that it really would benefit from just monitoring it at least periodically to ensure that this is not something that is happening silently in your body that would eventually lead to a more serious problem. My name is Sadeer Al-Kindi. I'm a cardiologist. I specialize in prevention of cardiovascular disease and imaging of cardiovascular disease. I usually recommend that my patients or people who I know check their blood pressure at least once a year. If they have no family history of high blood pressure, if they have no other conditions that may lead to blood pressure increases. And this is just to keep an eye on the blood pressure and making sure the more often you check it, the better. But I think at least once every year to 2 years might be reasonable for people who are at average risk. Blood pressure machines are actually fairly accurate. The vast majority of blood pressure machines that make it to the market have gone through some testing and validation to be relatively accurate. Now, the way that we measure the blood pressure is often problematic. And sometimes in these kiosks, for example, that are available in pharmacies, people walk in, they're either had some drinks previously, or you know they're just walking in, they're anxious. So there are a lot of different things that may add noise to the data that we get out of the blood pressure, more than the blood pressure being inaccurate itself, or the machine being inaccurate. There is a specific way of measuring blood pressure. I recommend usually to my patients that they measure it routinely so that you don't get nervous, especially the first few times. There are some anxiety around measuring blood pressure that can falsely or artificially elevate your blood pressure. Doing it routinely, doing it in the morning after waking up, emptying the bladder before drinking caffeine, go and sit down in an empty room, a quiet room for a few minutes. Have your back supported, be sitting in a chair, have your arm supported, have your legs supported, uncrossed, and then measure the blood pressure. Don't take the first blood pressure reading, but take the second one. And ideally, if you want to measure it three times and take the average of the second one and the third one, that would be even more ideal. The ideal way of measuring it is really you have to be on the skin to allow an ideal measurement and an accurate measurement because they depend on the pulsations of the arteries inside the arm, so they acquire that skin touch.